This is Matthias Björnmalm, and he's doing chemistry at about 50 meters per second. The tube he's clutching contains a sample of metal organic frameworks in the process of crystallizing. Björnmalm was part of a group of scientists investigating whether low gravity conditions would affect the size of the Mach crystals, potentially giving researchers a new tool to control Mach properties. They designed special injectors that allowed Björnmalm to mix two solutions just before jumping out of the plane.
We're gonna mix these two solutions, and it's gonna form Mach crystals.
Aside from wanting to commemorate the experience, the scientists recorded the experiment so they could show others precisely how it was done.
It is very fun to do, but it's also one of these things which we thought a lot about, how to convey how you actually did something.
Björnmalm is one of a growing number of chemists using action cameras like GoPros, cell phone cameras, and other inexpensive video equipment to record step-by-step experimental procedures. Chemists are taking this footage to prevent errors when others try to reproduce experiments and to prevent unsafe practices. Strapping a camera to yourself as you jump out of a plane is definitely on the extreme end of things, but these recordings are proving to be useful communication tools in labs and in journal articles. Back on Earth, Björnmalm and his colleagues also capture experimental procedures with a small action camera. This helps communicate information that might get lost in written instructions, especially when it comes to complicated, multi-step processes, Björnmalm says. For researchers who are new to a procedure, videos may offer useful tricks and safe techniques that more expert handlers take for granted.
These type of information can be very hard to convey on a piece of paper by writing down. If in a video you can see how someone takes something and moves it into another beaker or moves it into another reaction vessel.
Scientific journals are beginning to embrace videos too. The journal Chemistry of Materials, for example, launched a new article type in early 2017 that requires nuanced, detailed descriptions of how to synthesize substances and encourages videos. The goal is to help prevent reproducibility issues that arise from minor differences in interpretation of written instructions, says the journal's editor-in-chief, Jillian Biriak. Of course, parameters like where you bought your reagents or what settings you gave your instrument remain easier to convey on paper. But video can help complete the picture by showing details authors might otherwise overlook when writing articles.
The devil is in the details. Very subtle things can have a profound effect on the outcome of a reaction, but they're not described because someone doesn't think that they're important. There's no excuse anymore because everyone's carrying around a really good video camera.
Although the barrier to creating videos may be low, Biriak thinks that giving them a central role in scientific publishing will be a challenge, working against centuries of text-dominated history. The videos available today can be hard to find, relegated to supporting information sections, and often appearing in inconsistent formats. The journal eLife, which focuses on life sciences and biomedical research, is among those trying to better showcase videos. eLife's head of product, Giuliano Macciocci, says he believes that for readers to reap the full benefit of videos, they need to be as easy to engage with as the figures and text of an article. So the journal embeds videos directly within its articles, and developed technical infrastructure that would accommodate the variety of videos authors submitted. Videos are also helping chemists in both research and teaching labs. At Central New Mexico Community College, chemistry instructor Clarissa Sorensen-Unruh uses video to make instruments more accessible to a staff that includes several part-timers.
I'm gonna put my sample right on here.
Frequent turnover and scheduling conflicts made it difficult to formally train everyone on the equipment.
Between all of those moving pieces and everything changes every semester, something has to give there. It is, I think, imperative to give as many tools and as much preparation as possible in as many different ways as we can.
In Anna Larson's chemistry lab at Ithaca College, students themselves make videos showing the proper use of equipment from a chemist's eye view. Larson says the perspective helps students relate to what's happening on screen. Sometimes they even work with film students at the college to clearly communicate the procedures, exposing a new audience to what goes on inside the lab.
Oftentimes we see students kind of scared of anything that touches on chemistry. I believe the more outreach we can get to so-called lay audience, the better off everyone will be.
Back at Imperial College, Matthias Björnmalm is also building an inventory of training videos for instruments and procedures to complement in-person training for his group members, a practice he started with coworkers previously at the University of Melbourne.
We're not trying to make the next blockbuster movie where everything needs to be perfect. The key is trying to convey things that we're all passionate about and that we want to do well.
But to separate them?
Yeah.
Björnmalm says he sees video as a way to share that passion, not only with his colleagues and collaborators, but also with communities outside the lab and even outside the scientific community.
I think it can be very helpful to see what we do when we say we're in the lab and we're working on a new research project, that it's a lot less of a black box that researchers go away somewhere, do things, and come back with results. It's a lot more of a process.
Do you make videos a regular part of your lab work? Share your favorite video with us. You can post a link in the comments or email us here.